funds and putting it into your community, when you talk about ROI, it's not a straight line return on investment that you can always point to, but what it is, it's you can point to the great community that we have and that you're a supporter of that. So as this entrepreneurial ecosystem continues to develop, and we're seeing some great trends, a lot more diversity and minorities who are coming up as entrepreneurs, they need your support, and that support comes from community support.
Thank you, Josh. One thought is this, that we have some assets, we probably have some liabilities too. So I think it would probably serve us well. I heard the professor say earlier about the Houston in the first session having the launched the community engagement initiative. Okay. So in that first session, one of Ed's ideas is that to steward all of this, maybe there's a new body that has to be created. That's one thought. Because of every other body has, there's baggage that comes with that. The other thing is, what can we learn from other communities? Is it worth certain people maybe just going maybe to Austin, just to see what Austin has done, to maybe to accelerate a process? Maybe what I learned today, maybe going to Houston, seeing what's happening down in Houston, and kind of coming back when this next group comes together, and just take those ideas so we maybe learn from others' mistakes. Because when I put together the consulting program at TCU, that's what I did. I went to all the other universities and saw what they did and said, I'm going to take this, and put this together. So.
Outstanding. So looking around and learning. Johnny?
Yeah, in addition to the riffing on the economic development in general, you were talking about 25 net positive businesses coming out. I'm always more curious about one Michael Dell. One Dell is on that statistic is equivalent to one small Michael business. So I'm always curious what is who are the top businesses that are growing fast? It happens all the time in some communities I've been in. I'm just an outsider looking in, so I'm always thinking to myself, who's an Inc. 5000 company in Tarrant County? It could just be a catering company that grew from 10 to 50 employees over 2 years. I don't know what it did, but that's my first question. Is out of the 25 net, how do you help grow that one into the value of all 25? That's always what I'm curious. So that's more of a question, but it's something from outside that I'm looking in and saying, who are the top entrepreneurs? Who are the most, the people that may not have a platform, they're just so busy working all the time, you may not pay attention, but they are the foundation of, building up economic development, new jobs, et cetera, outside of large companies.
Outstanding. And what I like about that point of view, which is a little bit fresh on this conversation, is we're talking a lot about how to help businesses, and how many we have, and looking at the numbers, which is all healthy and good. But are we fostering the growth potential of those that have the potential to grow 100x or 1,000x? How do we spot those companies? How do we put the right people around those companies? You work with venture capital all the time. You've been working with venture capital certainly for 10 years, maybe longer. So in that question, how do we spot those growth companies?
I think there's a term for those growth companies. Those are called gazelles. If you've ever heard of that. Identifying the gazelles, those are very fast learning.
Yeah. Actually, we have a chart where we say, is this a gazelle company? And so what, I think it starts with just naming names. Instead of saying numbers, I just want to know if Steve Smith happens, who runs this company, has 40 employees, they do something. I'm always just curious on an individual basis story, who those people are, and going beyond numbers, who those people are, and then inviting them in. That's what I'm just curious about. Because I know that we have a panel of givers, and so when you're out there doing outreach, you're meeting these people, I just don't know who they are yet. And I think they'll naturally evolve and come up in conversations.
Can I join in here? Yes, sir. Sometimes to understand some of these things, I'm sorry, I'm going to introduce you to another concept into this, is what we call clusters. Clusters of businesses. A cluster is a group of businesses that are interlinked. So as we look into identifying these, and for the leaders that are on this panel, it is very, very important when we go into our communities, we want to understand what kind of clusters actually existing in our communities, and how can we engage them to be able to foster these clusters into growth? When we bring them on the table, then we have to talk about what kind of resources are actually helping you grow, and where do we come in? Is it a skills gap? Is it capital accumulation? Is it infrastructure development? What is lacking? So that is the idea that I alluded to earlier, that when we create a symposium where we bring in people who are going to stay here for about 8 hours talking about, you know, these things, by the end of the day, we have actually explosion of information that is beneficial for everybody else. And we can move that into the classroom and start preparing students who are actually going to go to work in industries that we already know that exist, because we understand the classes. So rather than, you know, going out and, you know, look in the phone book and see the entrepreneurs, the locksmith, the photocopier, and so on and so forth, first of all, understand what clusters exist in my area, and how can we build onto that?
Yeah, to add color to that, I'm also like you said, it's a great place to start filtering. So I think I heard, you know, suppliers of, they're a great example, going from 100 to 700 employees in any, you know, that might be, not be considered a big Fortune 100, right? So that still fits in a small medium business. I'm curious, you know, you can see it. I think adding color, like when I drive to the neighborhood, I see like there's a bunch of auto suppliers there. There's a bunch of car dealerships there, and that is its own natural cluster because it attracts people. And in this case, you know, I think you can see like craft breweries that happen to come up, or restaurants that happen to come up together. And so that's why I think just to add color to what, when you're identifying clusters, you can just see it naturally. Just drive around, like even to your office, like you said, you can see like a storefront of entrepreneurs kind of coming up kind of naturally.
Yes, and just for the record, I'm in favor of that craft brewery note. So when we talk about clusters, one of the things that's key to clusters is identifying nodes of growth, especially future growth around existing clusters, and then taking a look at nodes that may exist elsewhere but aren't as strong here. And I think software and IT, I think the application of software and systems and industry verticals that we already have here in the Metroplex are very, very strong with Fortune 1000 companies. So what are those nodes, those key threads? And I think every one of you could probably speak to this. Several of you, I think, are extremely well poised as you're seeing those businesses come through Northeast Tarrant County or Tarrant County. What are those threads that we need to start investing in and identifying those lead entrepreneurs and helping them to succeed here in the Metroplex?
I'm not going to talk about a particular thread, but I want to call the observation that I said it earlier this morning. You know, Liam Neeson in that one movie had a very specific set of skills. And I'm going to, you know, and that rings true because there are a lot of people that have a very specific set of skills, and they want to take that and they want to be a gazelle and move it forward. The challenge is that they lack the knowledge or the skill to take that and scale it, build that business. And so one fundamental piece that is lacking in this entrepreneurial ecosystem that we have designated as today as the founding day is, what the heck is a business plan? How do I start it? What's in it? What do I need? What information needs to be put into it? Al is not going to invest in a company that has a very specific skill set if they cannot demonstrate how they're going to return Hal's investment to him. And so I think that just the business planning, we have, again, a lot of skilled individuals, a lot of great ideas in our community. The capital's there, the initiatives are there, but how do we make that ecosystem? And Jack and I are working together on a business plan module where we have six meetings going through the nuts and bolts of a business plan. And my gosh, how refreshing it is. A lot of these people are already in business and their light bulbs are popping off. what they can take advantage of that they didn't realize they had a competitive advantage. And so going back to the thread is just threading that around. And for the cluster perspective, to the professor says, in case you're wondering, what are our clusters around here? It's very, very apparent. Aerospace, healthcare. Those are two that are our strongest clusters around here. So how do we think? Yeah, and that's input. And in case you're familiar with North Richmond Hills, Sonic. We have the most Sonics per square mile, but so we have a Sonic cluster here. But that's the concept of clustering. And so how do we thread that? And there's the key, in my humble opinion, I think Jack can attest, is the basics, blocking and tackling, and making sure that they have the support of the business plan. Once they have that, they can speak to Hal, they can speak to the banks.
Yeah, if I could just add on to what Craig's saying, we started this line of questioning on what we thought about economic development. And so from my perspective, clearly, economic development for our region, for whatever, is vital, it's the lifeblood. That's the only way we as communities are going to continue to prosper, is to, focus on economic development. But as an elected official, what I'll say is that it's probably more important at this point to be trying to move away from the traditional model of economic development and be thinking about how do we embrace the entrepreneur? How do we figure out ways, through business plans or whatever else, either symposiums, whatever we can do in this community to encourage and support and lift up those people so they can start their businesses wherever it is in our region, but in our communities. And for me, that's really what the elected official should be doing. We should be pushing those ideas, pushing that kind of concept, and not in saying, let's move away from the traditional style of economic development, saying, we want to blow this up and do it a whole lot differently and try to encourage people to branch out and to start a business and then find, let us as cities and communities, how do we help them grow them? So that would be my input to this comment.
Thank you. Ian?
Yeah, just it triggers something. And I guess we're sharing just the benefit of what you've done here today. So years ago, I did some consulting work for the Entrepreneurship Center, TCU, and actually did business plan. But the other thing is, we do the business plan competition in Fort Worth, but it's Tarrant County. I'd like to lend any assistance that I can on a volunteer basis to help you get that going. The other thing is, getting back to part of that sharing, is we've got an incubator, and there's not that many that are in the county. But where does an incubator, seller, whatever the hell you call it, where can that also play a role up here? And it really gets back to that exchanging of opportunities that we're sharing today.
Well, I think another important thing that was embedded in what you said, but I'll say because I know about it, is we're also offering slots in that incubator to the winners of the business plan competition. So if any of you have businesses, if you know people who have businesses who are sharp and on point and getting things done and growing their business and creating jobs, that is an avenue for them not only to get funding and to get some recognition, but also to get the support they need in the community. And increasingly, we're seeing that kind of interconnectivity take place. And I thank you very much for that, Ed. I think I saw another hand somewhere. Yes, sir.
Just to comment on top of what Mayor Griffin said, the clusters are definitely important. I think identifying the industries that are already present, right? So some of that were already listed off is medical, defense, manufacturing, logistics, those kind of things. Those are the established industries that are here locally. And we're already failing at really fostering growth for the entrepreneur, even within the industries that are identified. So towards talent development and future growth, some of the interesting things that we need to look at are the macro trends. So the fact that, Fort Worth is becoming, median age is lowering and lowering. So these jobs that people are looking for are these STEM-related jobs. We really need to invest a lot of time into understanding what is the need of the entrepreneur in order to not only help them foster the growth of the established business, but what does the established business not know that they need? The fact that there's so much IP that's shelved within our technologies and even our institutions here, there are so many ways that we can innovate by empowering the entrepreneurs, let them grab the tech, fulfill a need of some of these industry sectors that we have. And, you know, some of that is really just, it's bringing light to what we have. So as Rising Tide, and actually I'm going to say as we, as Rising Tide, you know, because it's not an I, you know, we hope that what we can do is bring everyone together and realize that this is a communal effort, that we have to be able to understand that UTARI exists, which is UT Health Start, which is UTA's robotics lab. We had somebody tour that and grab some IP and we didn't generate a business. Just through physical interaction, it's really surprising how much we don't know about the assets we have.
Yeah, I would agree with that. Matter of fact, in the last 4 or 5 meetings we've had over the last month, and we've had probably a lot more than that, but 4 or 5 that stand out where the entire conversation is around how do we find our entrepreneurs. In the Metroplex, we're so spread out in so many nodes and so many interesting people, but how do we find them and how do we get them where they need to be to get the resources they're looking for? I saw a couple of at least twitches over here in the center here. Linda, did you have something you wanted to share?
I just wanted to interject. I've been doing, and I'm not doing a plug for this, I'm doing a plug for everybody doing this kind of education, but we have this 3-part, there's 3 modules, and it's the Business Smart Toolkit, Ready, Set, Go. And it was developed by SBA, and with a focus on startup companies. And I got it, and I retooled it a little bit. I've been doing it as webinars that you can just pick up whatever module. I thought, well, I'll do this for a month or whatever. Let me tell you, the interest in it, we sent it out to our mail list of 6,000. The interest was just incredible. But now I'm finding, I do it in person in Dallas. I do it for work, but no one's asking me to do it. But at any rate, over at the Microsoft store, yesterday I did it, as 4.5, and it all went together. And I asked everybody, well, how many of you have a business, and how many of you are thinking of starting a business? 75% of the class already had the business. And I wrote it up as, it's time you know what you don't know, and you'd be surprised how many of them have been in business, no written business plan. And without that, you can't really go for financing. You can't really do much of anything. You can't really grow. It's amazing that they would even make it the first 2 years. But I think that kind of education is key. I think the more of it, the better. And doing it through the chamber couldn't be any better. I think you're on the right track.
Very good. And that's another example of combining resources. Did I hear you correctly, 66,000 emails?
56,000.
56,000.
If you invite me to partner with you and be part of your presentation, I'll put it out on that. I'll blast it out to those.
I'd like to announce a partnership that's just forming with the SBA, TCC, and everyone in the Rising Tide Initiative sitting up here that we're founding today, because that's the kind of connectivity that we need to get that mass of entrepreneurs mobilized and get them out there and doing what they need to be doing. Yes, sir.
I just wanted to add, I thought that was a great example of, like, you may not need to find the entrepreneur, they can come to you, right? You said 75% were entrepreneurs already. And so I think, you know, entrepreneurs are simple people, offer a little food, some coffee. Yeah.
Free webinar, by the way.
And tank showing. It's pretty, like, entrepreneurs are easy to get free.
Yeah, Kevin.
Cool. Yeah.
They tend to like the word free.
Yes.
Yeah.
So,
like,
how busy or successful they are, it's hard to pass that up. So if you can, like, especially for the people who are heads down entrepreneurs, they might, if you know them in your community, inviting them to speak is probably one of the best ways to just get them out, because otherwise they're probably working, and so they may not come to some events. But otherwise, a lot of times the entrepreneurs will come to you, host events, and they'll come out.
Very good. Anything else on that one? Yes, sir.
I just wanted to say, about 18 years ago, I worked in the TCU area, and there was this little taco place that we used to love, and it was just fabulous. But you go in there, the guys were tatted up, kind of like Craig, and they had these piercings, and they were serving you your food, and you're like, but the food was so good, and that you just loved it. It was Fuzzy's Taco Shop, right? And the owner was, and they were all just ahead of their time, kind of millennials, and now they've taken it. Now it took a different. It took getting involved with the right organizations and analysis by Buxton. But it was a college joint. Now on Fridays, my kids are like, let's go to Fuzzy's, and we have one right by our house in Grape Barn. There's one on Roof Snow. There's There's 8 or 9 in Northeast Tarrant County, over 50, I think, statewide. I would have never, ever guessed that that could have turned into the company that it is today.
Taco is a powerful form of currency. As a matter of fact, it's funny, and those of us from Austin have had a lot of fun with the city of San Antonio. Our mayors and President Obama had an ongoing dialogue for several years about who had the best tacos. And of course, Austin has the best tacos. There's no doubt about it. But now, I guess I've got a new home, so I need to find the best taco shop. So somebody help me out with that.
Yes, sir. I just have one quick the comment about finding out what you don't know. I think that's real important as we share our expertise in different things. When people come to me, it's amazing. You know, people have great ideas. People already have businesses that, you know, have been running, you know, 3, 4, 5 years, and we talked about this in the first session. They don't know how to scale it to that next level, to the 20 million, 50 million, 100 million, and they don't know what they don't know. And not knowing that you have to have a business plan, even if you're not looking for money, if you want your organization to grow, you have to have a plan. You have to have a current year budget, and you have to have a 5-year budget. You know, it's going to change. It's going to be a living animal, but you have to have a plan. And I think so many, especially the younger people, they don't know what they don't know. I think that's a very good point.
Well, and along the ideas of a plan, I would say that one of the things that's most crucial is having an exit strategy.
Absolutely.
And understanding what it is you actually want to get.